Before we continue with the rest of the video, we could use your help. Click that like button to help spread the word about Watch JoJo, and also be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss our future videos. This river rocket was once the pride of Soviet waterways, but now it's rusting in peace. The Soviet Union never did manage to put a man on the moon, but it did succeed in engineering a lot of groundbreaking technology, such as the world's first satellite and orbital space station. Few people outside of the former Eastern Bloc, however, will be familiar with what may be the Soviets' most enviable invention, the Raketa. Raketa means rocket in Russian, and the Soviets know how to build good rockets. After all, they did put the first man in space. But Raketa was not designed to fly, well, at least not through the sky. Sometimes resembling some sort of intergalactic spaceship, Raketa was a distinctly Soviet transport device. It was designed by Rostislav Alexeyev, a brilliant Russian engineer responsible for experimental vehicles such as the Caspian Sea Monster, a ground vehicle capable of flying over open water. Although it couldn't actually fly, Raketa's elevated hull, lifted by fins on its underside, provided a reduced surface friction and a higher velocity than traditional boat designs. Raketa was a first-generation Soviet hydrofoil, mass-produced for mass transit. Raketa 1, the prototype model, was assembled at Krasnoye-Sormovo, one of Russia's oldest and most famous shipbuilding yards. Based in the city of Nizhny Novgorod, about 250 miles east of Moscow, the plant dates back to 1849 and the Russian Empire. Raketa 1 embarked on its first voyage on August 25, 1957. Carrying 30 passengers, it traveled the 260 miles along the River Volga from Nizhny Novgorod to Kazan. Its average speed was 37 miles per hour, and the journey took 7 hours. "Enough of stumbling around rivers in some rusty tubs," declared Nikita Khrushchev, leader of the Soviet Union. "Let's travel in style." In that spirit, Raketas and other hydrofoils were rolled out for public use in the decades to follow. However, in 1991, the ending of the Cold War signaled the sudden political and economic collapse of the Soviet Union, and production of Raketas ceased. Today, hundreds of them are quietly decaying in spooky Raketa graveyards. One such graveyard was explored by a base-jumping daredevil known as Base Guru, whose Russian-language blog features photos of his most daring feats. At an old shipbuilding base near Kama Reservoir and the city of Perm, however, Base Guru photographed a more sedate scene of the decaying remnants of the Soviet past. As he wandered around the yard, Base Guru encountered fleets of decommissioned vessels, eerie, dilapidated ghost ships abandoned to decay. "The base was in sad condition," he wrote on his blog. Dispatched to the Volga and other Soviet rivers, Raketas were once an integral part of daily life in the USSR. Citizens used them for both transport and leisure. Not only a popular way of getting around, the Raketa also spawned generations of innovative and ever faster new river craft. The Meteor, for example, was a second-generation Raketa with capacity for 160 passengers and was popular with weekend cruisers. The Kometa, meanwhile, was a seafaring Raketa released in 1961. Surrounded by the amber tones of autumnal leaves, Base Guru discovered an old meteor. Where had it traveled? Who had it carried? And would it ever sail again? Base Guru decided to get a closer look. As he clambered between the rusty hulks, he recalled his childhood memories on the Dnieper River. 20 years later, I again went up to the deck of the ship," he wrote. "The broken window blew the wind from the river, mingled with nostalgia. On board, these seats were sagging, the cushions torn, random debris was scattered around the aisles, and the floor was coated with grime. The old Raketa had seen better days and would probably never sail again." On one tabletop, there was a weathered old book that resembled a sailing almanac, its pages warped from damp. The date on its cover was 1990. Just 1 year before the fall of the Soviet Union. Fortunately, not all Raketas have met such a sad fate. In fact, many continue to be used in countries outside Russia, including Greece and Thailand. Others have been modified for other uses. One well-to-do Russian has converted his Raketa into a luxury yacht, for example. And if you fancy renovating a Raketa yourself, they can be found for sale on specialist boating websites. Prices vary, but a decent, well-kept Raketa might set you back a cool $300,000 to $400,000. If you can't afford the price tag, though, an entirely new generation of Raketas is currently under development at Nizhny Novgorod Shipyard. The new vessels will have capacity for 120 passengers and will service the Black Sea. Until then, you can always travel to the former Soviet Union and find a Raketa graveyard, just like Base Guru did. After concluding his tour of the abandoned ships, he celebrated by free climbing some civic artwork. But of course, you don't have to do the same. Please don't forget to subscribe and activate the bell to receive everything that's new.